här är operasångaren och superstjärnan Luciano Pavarotti. Och TV2-kvällen ska närmast fortsätta med en amerikansk underhållning kring och med honom. 20:50, astronomi, det är ett informationsprogram om en ny serie från Utbildningsradio. Klockan 21, kanal 3, som ställer frågan, vem är den bästa förebilden i kampen mot våld och förtryck? Gandhi, Marx eller Jesus? Senaste nytt från svenskt och internationellt nöjesliv blir det i Nöjesnytt klockan 22. Och TV2-kvällen avslutas mellan 22:15 och 23:05 i Öresund. Rockmeny från båda sidor sundet.
Ladies and gentlemen, Pavarotti and Friends, starring Luciano Pavarotti with his family and friends, Jacqueline Bisset, John McEnroe, Fernando Pavarotti, Richard Thomas, John Williams, and the Orchestra Stabile Emilia Romagna, under the direction of Maestro Leone Maggiera.
This is the city where I was born and where I grew up. It's generally sunny, but today is wet. It is in central Italy, and it is called Modena. I have left here many times to go out into the world and perform. But I always come home every chance I get. Wherever I travel, people have been most kind and generous with their friendship, welcoming me into their homes and treating me like one of the family. I like to do the same thing when friends visit me here.
If you're a friend of the Pavarotti family, you're automatically a member of the Pavarotti family. They accept you totally and with great warmth. There's a lot of people who say, drop in when you're in the neighborhood, and hope you never will. But when a member of the Pavarotti family says it, it's more like an order than a social courtesy.
Attenzione sul primo binario, treno in manovra. Allontanarsi dal primo binario. Attenzione al primo binario.
Recently, I found myself in the neighborhood on my way to London. And of course, I decided to drop in.
Scusi, mi hanno mandato alla stazione centrale per cercare una persona speciale. Lei è la signora Jacqueline Bisset?
Sì, sì. Hello. I have a suitcase. Valigi.
Ah, valigia.
It's very heavy. Careful. Pesante.
Ah, pesante. Yes.
Andiamo. I don't want to miss lunch. I give you a hand. Una, due, tre.
Tre.
Oh.
Now, Rome may be the eternal city, and Venice may have those exotic canals, and Florence great works of art. But to me, the charm of Italy is really to be found in places like Modena. It's the kind of place where the past and the present are in perfect balance. I happen to love this ride from the train station to the Pavarotti house, because there's a warm welcome waiting for me at the end of the ride.
Ciao! Thank you.
Luciano, his wife Angela, and his three lovely daughters, Lorenza, Christina and Giuliana always make it a point of greeting their guests personally.
What about
you? Don't get anything.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Am
to
I
be
late for
here.
Lunch?
And
yes,
of course, Mama okay. And Papa.
Okay. Wow.
One of the things I share with the Pavarotti family is a love of good food. It doesn't have to be fancy or exotic, just delicious.
Zachary! Piti,
Andrew's a marvelous cook, and unlike most great cooks, she is willing to share her recipes. And that's just one more reason why I love to come here.
Caro.
Fantastic! It's perfect! You sound like a television commercial. You always use fresh herbs, right?
That is right.
Fresh is always best.
What can I do to help?
Stay out of the kitchen.
Don't you have anything to do?
I have plenty to do. I must go to the opera house to rehearse, and there is a painting I am working on that I would like to finish.
Can I see it?
But you have plenty to do here in the kitchen.
Well, Agua, I know I'm indispensable, but I would like to see your etchings.
Anything to get him out of the kitchen.
Great. Marcy, you turned this room into a studio.
They sent me here.
I like.
Really?
Yes. There's tremendous joy in these paintings.
I enjoy the color. Nothing else.
You know, opera's a funny thing, because so many people are put off it for different reasons. I always loved ballet all my life. I started going to see Covent Garden when I was
I
about
can't
three.
See. No, you can't be a dancer
see.
Yourself.
No, wait, just wait a minute. But my mother always took me to see really good ballets, and I had a wonderful education in that. But in opera, she took me to see, I think I was about 11 or 12, I went to see Boris Godunov.
Oh, that.
With Boris Christoph.
Heavy stuff.
Heavy stuff.
Yes.
And as the opera continued, and they never sang above middle C as far as I was concerned. I mean, it was right round here. And I was sitting in my chair, completely down in the chair. She kept saying, sit up, Jacqueline, sit up, for God's sake. I can't sit up unless they sing higher. And I used to think, I'd never sit through another opera of this heaviness again. But I would like you to tell me what I should go and see and what young people should go and see when they start.
I think young people, first of all, they must go to the opera to see an opera where is no dead on the stage, no dead people on the stage, an happy opera.
A happy what?
Yes, I think it must be a nice, a very sweet opera. I don't say light, but it must be funny, it must be enjoyed.
Give me
go out.
Names.
Well, all the opera who are comic, who is Barbieri di Siviglia, Elixir of Love, Don Pasquale, all these kind of things. And with an happy ending.
What is your favorite opera?
I don't have any. I have three daughters, and if you ask me which one is my favorite, I don't know. And the same of the opera. If I'm singing Elixir of Love, is Elixir of Love. If I'm singing Aida, is Aida, is the role I am singing.
You have to go to rehearsal.
And you have to go to the kitchen.
Let's go.
Let's go. Yeah.
I still want this one.
People sometimes ask me if I ever get tired of singing the same role over and over again. But really, it is different every time. The singers change, the orchestra change, the audience, conductor, and set change. The only thing the same is you. And you change too, because of all the things around you. Opera is a living thing. Every night is different. So if I do a production of Aida at La Scala, at the Met, or even here at the beautiful opera house in Modena, it is like three different roles. That is why I enjoy rehearsal so much. I always learn new things from the people around me.
Sogno s'avverasse. Un esercito di prodi da me guidato. E di tutto. Dirti, per te ho pugnato, per te ho vinto.
What's happened to Luciano? He's half an hour late.
Oh, he stops to talk sometimes.
All the time.
Just in time. I brought back some friends from the theater. They all want to see you. I invite them to stay for dinner.
Yeah?
Jackie! Oh, come in. Che piacere, grazie di essere venuto.
Come in. Avanti, avanti. Hey, wait, hey. Well, calma, mangiamo, eh. Let's see, let's see. Mangiare, oh, let's go, let's go, let's go. Hollywood, California is many miles from Modena, Italy. One place I know very well, the other I have come to know over the past few years. A very good friend of mine lives here. His name is Richard Thomas. He's a very fine actor and a very bright young man.
We first met 6 years ago at a department store in New York. Here I was signing record albums. We met and talked and found we like each other very much. I also learned he knows a great deal about opera. And he learned I know very little about American television. Yet our friendship flourished.
When I first met Luciano, I was starring in a television series, and he was already an internationally known opera star. At the time, we had two things in common, our love for opera and our love for performing. Well, these days, we have another thing in common. We are each the father of 3 daughters. And when my triplets were born, Luciano and his wife and their daughters were the first people to come visit my girls in the hospital.
Oh, you looked like the very proud father that day.
Proud. Stunned is more like it. Can you imagine what it's like to start the day with 3 members in your family and finish the day with 6?
Oh, no.
Neither can I. Even if you know it's going to be 3, and of course we didn't, it's incomprehensible. There's no way you can prepare yourself for it until you begin to look at them and hold them and feed them.
And diaper them. And,
exactly. That's good. When the reality sets in.
Yeah.
We never know what life has in store for us, do we? Or take you, for instance. One day you're selling insurance, the next day you're singing Rodolfo in La Boheme, and the day after that, bam, you're a movie star.
It took more than 3 days for it to happen.
I know, but really, when you were growing up, did you ever dream you'd be in the movies?
No, my dreams were never so great. I remember going to the movie to see Mario Lanza singing all this beautiful song. And it was my idol. And running home in front of the mirror, trying to imitate him, and with my voice, my tonsil always coming out.
That's Do you know he was so talented that he actually made a movie once in which he never even appeared and he was still the best thing in it?
How happened?
Oh, it's true. It was a picture called The Student Prince, and they hired Lanza to play the lead, and he had already made the vocal tracks with orchestra. But before they actually started the shooting, he got into a contract dispute with the studio.
Sure, what they did?
Well, the studio, of course, they had all these fabulous vocal tracks that they didn't want to waste. So they hired an actor to play the part Lanza was supposed to play. Yes, this is true. And whenever the character was supposed to sing, they used Lanza's singing voice.
But I think they should have called it the Silent Prince.
Well, you're joking, but did you realize that there were several silent versions of operas?
Well, now you are joking.
No, no, I'm very serious. There was a silent movie based on the opera Carmen. Very unusual casting. Charlie Chaplin played the part of Don Jose.
It's true. Favorite opera film too.
Yes, knowing you, it's probably Aida, starring Sophia Loren.
Oh, if I remember, when Renata Tebaldi gives her beautiful voice to Sophia. Do you know it was Sophia's debut in the movie?
No, I didn't know.
She was just 17. Hmm. What a marvelous chest tone. But that was not the movie I was talking about.
Who is in the picture you're talking about?
Arpo, Chico, and Groucho. It's called A Night at the Opera.
What was that, high C or vitamin D? Now we're getting somewhere.
Oh, in alto, in alto, in alto, che trafiderlo, trafiderlo. Questa mano, le mie fibre a vuoto gelo corre tanti arrivi dir. Se mi spegnete lo occhio fra poco,
okay, all right, it's my turn now. What singer gave the most earth-shaking performance in the history of films?
I give up.
It had to be Jeanette MacDonald in San Francisco.
Some vibrato to shake the entire city.
Okay, I have the last one. Who was the biggest star ever to sing opera in the movies?
I guess Caruso.
Wrong. Willie.
Willie?
Willie.
Why was so famous Willie?
You never heard of Willie?
No.
His last name was Whale.
Willie Well?
No, no, not Willie Whale. Willie the Whale. Walt Disney made him a big star using the voice of Nelson Eddy. Now that you've made your own picture, the talk of the town is that you're going to be the most popular opera movie star since Willie the Whale.
I don't think so, but I hope for the best.
I do too.
I play the character in this movie of a famous singer called Giorgio, who come back to America and he fall in love with a beautiful girl.
I see. Well, between all the love scenes, I hope you have time to sing a little bit of opera, some arias.
I sing many arias and even one song in English.
Oh, that's great.
It's great for you because it's your native language, but not for me.
I'm sure it's wonderful.
It's a big trouble, takes a lot of time.
Who's the composer?
The composer is a genius, John Williams.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And the writer are the Bergmans. I think the song is very good, fantastic. It's called If We Were in Love.
Like this. Approximately there.
Could the skies be any bluer than they are?
Not too slow.
Could our smiles be any warmer, a kiss be any sweeter, if we were in love? And could we seem any closer to a star?
I'm in another key right underneath.
Yes.
I think a lot of that went on in this room, Luciano. A lot of those modulations and soaring sweeps in pictures, you know, MGM in the past.
I got.
In this place.
Emerald
do you
Square.
Know? Do you know the American musical pictures? A lot of them you know, Singing in the Rain and American in Paris and all those things. You know those things?
Yeah,
they're fabulous.
Jane Kelly.
Kelly and Fred Astaire. And it was done here, in this place, you know.
For me, what really is a little scaring is probably the last movie about opera, which was made here with Mario Lanza, when he made all the movie here. And now, after so many years, to go back, I'm telling you, I put myself on the spot, really.
I think it's something worth doing, that's the point.
It's true.
No, I don't think there's any risk for you.
All the friends of mine in my native city in Italy, they say, what are you going to do? Take you 20 years to build your career at that point, and now you make a movie and you will destroy everything. If it's the case, we will not make any more. But it's so exciting. And then I found so beautiful work here in this... these people, then every morning, even at 6 o'clock, who is for a singer?
It's the middle of the night.
It's the middle of the night, really. I was every morning there with pleasure, except the first 2 mornings, then I fall asleep under the makeup. And after that, it was a constant pleasure because everybody around really super professional and an incredible feeling. I thought my word of opera, it was the most serious, and I am still thinking so, but the movie world is equally serious, and for somebody who really want to do creative things,
why not?
It's the only way.
Why not?
There is no. Can we do one more?
So, yeah, you want a different beginning?
Okay.
Okay, we're gonna play. Do that.
Okay, girls, come on. Time for lunch. I'll take you home. Good luck with the picture.
Thank you.
Can you say goodbye to your Uncle Luciano, girls? Say goodbye to your Uncle Luciano, girls. Is that nice?
I guess they wait for my reviews to come out.
Yeah, I know. Everybody's a critic. Good luck with it anyway.
Oh, thank you. Say hello to Alma for me.
I sure will. What's the matter with you ladies? A man's a very big star. Someday he may need to make a picture and need triplets. You got a lot to learn about the business, girl.
Good volley by Mac.
Number one, primo, numero uno. No matter how you say it, and no matter how much you may yearn to have that title,
you are never prepared for the pressure and the responsibility that go along with it. John McEnroe is number one at his profession, and he became the best when he was barely out of his teens. Tennis is a very demanding game, and when it is your nature to be a perfectionist, it is easy sometimes to be misunderstood.
How can you say that? I can't believe you said that. You know where the line is? Well, I know where the line is.
So do I. The line between talent and greatness is determined by the amount of effort you put into your job.
No, it's not. It's the ability to overcome obstacles.
Effort.
Obstacles.
Why do you argue with me?
It's not you. I think maybe it's the chair.
Oh, in that case, I will calm down. I still say it is effort.
Maybe you're right.
Oh, maybe it was the chair. You know, we are not that different, you and I.
Yeah, I heard you used to be a soccer player when you were young.
True. In Modena, I spent all my time on the soccer field.
Well, I played a lot of soccer when I was young. Stanford University soccer coach wanted me to play soccer as well as tennis. You know, I think we both made the right decisions. But even opera and tennis have a lot in common. They both require dedication and discipline.
Yes, but when you are there on the court, there is no libretto to follow. You make it up as you go along, and you show all your emotion in your face.
I take a lot of flack for exposing my emotions on the court.
Oh, it is hard to be an emotional when you are concentrating so hard on one objective. What do you do to relax?
I go to a lot of rock concerts and recently been fooling around with a guitar.